Okay, now, see, I was explaining to you what is the meaning of middle one-third rule. See here, in middle one-third rule, again we have to apply the no tension condition. मतलब यहाँ पे मैं आपको ये बताऊँगा कि load को हमें किधर place करना है in a rectangle. See, in simple words, what is the meaning of middle one-third rule? Middle one-third rule का meaning है कि हम लोग यहाँ पे load को किधर place करेंगे, जिसकी वजह से इस section में tension नहीं आए. Means here it should be only pure compression, no tension in this section. Okay. So middle one-third rule के लिए we would be using the no tension condition. Is it fine? So I will write down here that using no tension condition, using no tension condition, और no tension condition हमें क्या बताता है? That your direct stress should always be greater than or equal to bending stress. Fine, ये आपको याद रखना है. This is your no tension condition. Okay, therefore direct stress is load upon area, bending stress is M by Z, and M by Z is P into E upon Z. ठीक है. Next, here I can write down, therefore it is P upon area is B into D greater than or equal to P into E. अभी Z हम लोग जब calculate करेंगे, see here, this middle third rule which I am teaching to you all, middle third rule, one third rule, that will be with respect to X as well as with respect to Y. So first I will write down Z, the Z which I have written, ये है Z axis. Okay, and what is Z axis? Z XX is equal to IXX upon Y. And what is IXX? IXX is BD cube by 12 divided by Y. And what is Y? Y is D by 2. So ZXX is equal to BD square by 6. Similarly, हम लोग लिख सकते हैं ZYY is equal to, इसका reverse, तो वो हो जाएगा db square by 6. ठीक है, तो पहले हम लोग लिखेंगे ZXX is BD square by 6. Is that okay? Left hand side, right hand side, दोनों में से P cancel, B gets cancelled, here also B gets cancelled, D cancel, इधर से एक D cancel. Yes, okay, what happens here I have D by 6, ये उधर चला जाएगा, so this would be, therefore eccentricity I can write down should be less than or equal to D by 6. Okay, अभी ये D by 6 हम लोग mark करेंगे on this. If I have D here, then D by 6 will be somewhere here. एक तो top पे मैंने mark किया, then at the bottom. Okay, so this distance I am saying that it is D by 6. This is D by 6. D by 6 from top and D by 6 from bottom. D divided by 6. ठीक है. So if I add this, eccentricity D by 6 मुझे मिला है from the center on y axis. सिर्फ एक ही साइड पे, अगर वो दोनों साइड पे है तो that becomes eccentricity will be, total eccentricity will be D by 6 plus D by 6, that would be 2D by 6 and that becomes D by 3. So the total eccentricity is D by 3, मतलब ये जो total है that is D by 3. Fine, ये हुआ for XX. Now let me show you for YY, उसमें क्या difference आएगा. Okay, instead of ZXX, I will write down ZYY. So I have P upon A greater than or equal to P into E upon ZYY. ठीक है. So P upon area is B into D greater than or equal to P into E. ZYY is DB square by 6. Okay. अभी यहाँ अगर मैं देखता हूँ, I can cancel it out, P and P, B और B, yahan se d aur d gets cancelled. So what is remaining? Eccentricity e is less than equal to b by 6. So here I have b by 6. Main ek side pe mark karta hu. Suppose on this side I mark b divided by 6. On the other side also I have to mark b by 6. ठीक है. अभी b by 6 is on one side. If I calculate total, so that would be capital E is equal to b by 6 plus b by 6, and in other words that is equal to b by 3. ठीक है. So now I have got 1, 2, 3, 4. These 4 points I can join them. Okay. And then I can draw a section here. Now this section which I have got, it is called as core of a section. It is called as core of a section. ठीक है. और इस रूल को, why it is called as middle 1/3 rule? क्योंकि मिडिल से at a time you are taking the distance that is 1/3.